I have to stand on this red dot here, which is very unusual for me. So maybe I'm going to focus on the dot, but I'll try connecting with you. Before I start my talk, there's two things you should know. First of all, I'm manically positive. I think everything can be done. And the second thing is, I get this fight with money all the time. Everything I want to achieve something, money comes in the way. And at a certain moment, I decided, this money I'm using to buy stuff in order to achieve the goals I want. Now, what would happen if I don't use money, but just ask for the things I want? And a funny thing happened, because people started giving me the things I need, and I will give a couple of examples. But then, somehow along the way, and I'm convinced this goes for everybody in Holland, we've agreed with ourselves that it's impolite to ask for help. We've agreed that you have to camouflage your mistakes and share your success in order to be seen as a successful person. And I think it's stupid. Because I know for sure that you leave an enormous resource unused. So by not asking for help, you're keeping yourself from achieving your goal in a more fun way, faster than ever before, with more people than ever before. Now, a couple of years ago, this guy came up to me. I started organizing this workshop. This is a simple medicine. You find 8 people that don't know each other. You put them down in a circle, and you invite them to ask for help. Every time that you do that, these 8 people will start helping. Now, in one of those workshops, there was this guy called Gerrit, and he's a carpenter. He makes furniture. And he asked this question, Niels, I want to make my furniture capacities for use to society. What can I do? And we talked about it for a while, and then I agreed with him that every time I meet somebody or I have to talk in front of an audience, I will ask them if they have a little piece of wood lying around in their house. Which one of you at home has this little piece of wood he's not going to be using anymore? Please raise your hands. Okay, look around. That's almost everybody. I just walked out before I had to do my talk. Even in front of the door here, there's wood lying around. Now, the thing is, this one piece of wood may seem useless. But if you have 1,000 of those pieces, you can make beautiful furniture. And that's exactly what we did. We started off in my own street, in my hometown, Nijmegen, with trembling hands. You have this, I said to myself, oh, nobody gonna catch this story. So pushing doorbells everywhere. And I explained, I think if you connect all the little pieces of wood in the world, you can make beautiful furniture. Do you have a bit of wood I can have? And I had this minivan, which was stuffed with wood at the end. So then I found out, if you connect all the little bits in the world that seem useless, they get to use again. They become useful resources. Now, this is not only happening with stuff, this is also happening with the helping power we have lying around. Because another thing I discovered is, people love to help. And we can prove it here. In the introduction, Tim said, the people who came here by train or by boat or by taxi can't have their road back. Which one of you in the audience is here by car? Please raise your hands. Which one of you would be willing to take somebody back to the station? Please raise your hands. Okay, this is what's happening everywhere. The people without a car, I hope you've been looking, because they're here. Here's your rights. You know, they're here. The help is sitting right next to you at this very moment. Now, if you've agreed with yourself not to ask for help, just realize what resources you're not using. Now, so we made this table, and then I found out that if people like to help, and we live in a world of plenty, but it's lying around at the wrong place, being unused, what would happen if you focus that energy on solving social problems? If you gather all that abundance, all those people and all those stuff. Now, in order to get people together, you need a room. So I called up this housing company in Nijmegen. I said, listen up, I don't have any money because I think it's a... Well, it doesn't help me all the time, but do you have a little spare room we could use to put people together to solve some society problems? And they gave me the key to a building. And this building was supposed to be torn down 2 years ago. So they said, nobody's going to rent it anyway. So they gave me a building for free. And I knew this might work because maybe some of you know, in Holland, we have 7 million square meters of office building not being used, abandoned at this very moment, 7 million square meters. And 2 years ago, they found out we have 18,000 homeless people. This means, per homeless people, we have 400 square meters lying around being unused. And they're not allowed in. This is 4 times the size of my house, and I'm with 3. It shocks me. So I asked for a little room, and I got a building. Now, if somebody gives you a building, there's about 32 people working there as we speak, then you have to raise the bar a bit. So we decided we wanted to furniture the building within a week. And the first thing we needed was to paint the walls. Now, just to test, which one of you at home has this little can of paint which just isn't enough to do the wall one more time? Please raise your hands. Look around. Now, at your house, it may seem useless, but I know by experience, if you collect all that paint, it will turn out to be gray or brown, which is pretty up-to-date at the moment, and you can paint an entire building. You don't need money, you need paint. Now, if you want furniture, you don't need money to buy it, you need wood to build it. And what we did also at this working place in Nijmegen, we made our wish list, the things we needed, and we put it online. Any one of you having his birthday pretty soon now? No one? Over there? Do you know what you want to have for your birthday? Here. More. Just more. More happiness, I hope. Most people don't even know what they want for their birthday. On our wish list, one of the topics is coffee. Now, if you're ever in Nijmegen and you need a place to work, please come to our place. There's always free coffee because we have loads of them. There's always free wine because after a lot of talks I do, I get a bottle of wine and I don't drink alcohol, so it's over there as well. And there's always free internet. So building one of those places is easy and is possible without money. Now, if you can build one of those places, we decided let's raise the bar a bit more. And we invited people to join in on social matters like education, sustainability, transportation. And in a week time, 2,000 people started off their own projects all over Holland. And there were 2 rules. The first one is, if you're afraid to fail, don't come. Which is a very important one, because I found many people spent the majority of their time camouflaging their failures, because they are afraid people will say something about it. So if you're afraid to fail, please don't come. The second rule is, you can't have any money involved. Yet, at the same time, there were 2,000 people in 1 week realizing 137 projects, which amazed me. And then a couple of years, I started off this hashtag on Twitter called Durf te Vragen in Dutch, Dare to Ask. It now has a daily reach of about 200,000 people a day. These are 200,000 persons wanting to help each other. These are the resources we are not using. And we're not using them because we've collectively decided that it's impolite to ask. And you're wrong. And why are you wrong? Because people get happy from helping. So by not asking, you're actually keeping them from becoming a bit more happy. Now, knowing this, what would this mean for you? There's a couple of things you may want to take home with you. First of all these people weren't coming out to help me. They were coming out to solving these problems. So I found out that the mountain you want to move has to be sexy and appealing to a big group of people. So you can ask yourself, what is it you want to achieve? What dream is it you want to realize? What mountain is it you want to move? The next question you can ask for yourself is, what do you need in order to move that mountain? And there will be a couple of guys here sitting and saying, it's funding. For 5 minutes, please, if you have a business plan, lie your hand over the financial paragraph and look at what you would buy for it and start asking for that. Because if your goal is sexy and appealing enough, if people are attracted to the mountain that you want to move, they will come out and help. So here at this very moment, what you can do is think up of your wish list and look around you. For if you take a chance and if you get rid of the assumption that it's impolite to ask, the person that has access to the resources you need may be sitting right next to you as we speak. Take a chance, for I'm sure you too can move mountains if you choose to. Thank you.